Hi, everyone. Today's video is about pneumatic spray nozzles. A pneumatic spray nozzle is a nozzle that mixes liquid and air in the nozzle to produce very fine atomization. It has a big advantage that you can easily adjust the spray flow rate and spray droplet size by adjusting the liquid and air supply pressures.
For example, if you want to double the spray flow rate, it's pretty hard to do it with a hydraulic nozzle that only uses liquid. The flow rate of hydraulic spray nozzles is determined by liquid pressure. To double the spray flow rate, liquid pressure must be increased by 4 times, which may require new equipment. It is easier to switch to a different nozzle instead. Additionally, it is not possible to adjust the spray droplet size with the same hydraulic nozzle. On the other hand, with a pneumatic nozzle, you can double the spray flow rate by simply adjusting the liquid and air valves. To adjust the spray with a pneumatic spray nozzle, you need to know how much liquid and air are being sprayed. At what pressure? To obtain the information, we use a flow rate diagram, which I will explain today. If you understand how to read flow rate diagrams, you can easily control the spraying conditions. Take for example, the BIM series producing fine atomization. First, we'll explain using a flow rate diagram for one of the BIM series models, and then we'll show you spray demonstrations. Let's start with the flow rate diagram. From the diagram, you can read the liquid spray flow rate and pressure, the air consumption and pressure, and the mean droplet diameter. Spray flow rate is on the horizontal axis, and air consumption is on the vertical axis. The blue and red lines indicate the liquid and air pressures, respectively. The blue line indicates the liquid pressure, like this. The liquid pressure is at the end of the lines, from 0.1 MPa to 0.5 MPa. By contrast, the red line indicates compressed air pressure. The air pressure is at the left end. W of PAR represents water, and A of PAR represents air. The pressure lines are shown by increments of 0.1 MPa only with nice round numbers. But imagine that there are countless lines in between. For example, right in the middle of the liquid lines PW equals 0.1 and 0.2 MPa. There is a liquid pressure of 0.15 MPa. The area enclosed by this line is the allowable spray range for this nozzle. Outside the range, around here, spraying will fail or cause hunting. Now let's try reading specific figures. Look at this point, for example. At this point, for the spray flow rate, look at the water amount down below. It is 6.3 liters per hour. The liquid pressure at this point is at the end of the blue line, so it's 0.3 MPa. In contrast, for the air consumption, look at the vertical axis. It is 20 normal liters per minute. And also the air pressure at that point is 0.4 MPa, above the red line.
Lastly, look at these green lines. The green lines represent what we call the air-water ratio. Air-water ratio is the ratio of water and air consumption per the same hour. For example, at this point, the water is 6 liters per hour, and the air is 10 normal liters per minute. When converted to hours, 600 normal liters per hour of compressed air is consumed. So, in terms of ratio, the air-water ratio is 600 over 6, which means, for one part of water, 100 parts of air is used. This green line indicates all the points with the same air-water ratio of 100. Similarly, the green lines at 150, 300, and 500 indicate points with the same air-water ratio. The higher the air-water ratio is, the finer the spray droplet size becomes. Look, when the air-water ratio is around 100, the spray droplet size is 60 micrometers, and when the ratio is around 500, the spray droplet size is 20 micrometers. Now that you have learned how to interpret our flow rate diagram, let's move on to adjust the spray based on the diagram. We will guide you through two types of adjustments. First one is changing the spray droplet size while maintaining a constant spray flow rate. We will adjust the spray at this initial point too. This point, aiming to change the spray droplet size while keeping the spray flow rate constant. The spray flow rate, set at 4 liters per hour, remains consistent, but you can see the spray droplet size is reduced by half, from approximately 40 micrometers to 20 micrometers. Later on, we'll show you a demonstration of the spray. Second, let's move this initial spray point to increase the spray flow rate while keeping the spray droplet size constant. The spray droplet size will remain the same at about 40 micrometers, but the spray flow rate will increase from the initial 4 liters per hour to approximately 9 liters per hour. Demonstrations of the spray before and after this adjustment will be shown later. Furthermore, let's observe how the spray appears in areas where spraying is not recommended, such as here and here on the diagram. Later on in this video, the demonstration shows these instances where spraying fails or becomes unstable. In this case, after the adjustment, with higher liquid and air pressures, the spray flow rate remains the same, but the spray droplet size becomes smaller. You can see, on the right, finer spray droplets with higher velocity, causing more to bounce when the spray hits the palm. You can see that spray flow rate is more than doubled, but spray droplet size remains the same. In the non-recommended range, such as these, the desired spray will not be achieved. Thank you for watching to the end. That's all for today's video. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to the channel. See you next time.